Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can run C and C++ programs in Visual Studio Code. Now here, I will explain how we can download and install a compiler, how to download and install Visual Studio Code, and how to set up VS Code in order to run C and C++ programs. Now, if you are interested in only a particular section, then the timestamp will be available in the description box. You guys can check that out. So the first thing that we do is we will install the C++ compiler. In order to do that, we will open up the browser. I have Microsoft Edge and I have opened that. Here in the URL bar, enter the website address msys2.org and open up this website. MSYS2 is a software distribution and building platform for Windows. By using this, we can install the C++ compilers. Here in the installation section, we can see download the installer option. And below that, we can see how we can install it and how we can install some packages. What we do is we will download this installer by clicking on this. Now, depending on when you're watching this video, this version number can be different. You don't have to worry about that. Now, once the download is complete, if I take the cursor, I can find this open file option. Click on that. It will open up the MSYS2 setup window. And here we will install the MSYS2. So we will click on next and make a note of this path. And then click on next. We will not change anything. We will click on next and it will install. We will just wait for the installation to finish. Okay, now the setup is complete. Now we will check this box which says run MSYS2 now, and then we will click on finish. Now here it will open up the terminal window with this UCRT runtime option. The first thing that we do is we will update the packages. So we will type in pacman space minus capital S Y U and hit the enter button. Now if any updates are available, then it will display that here. Now for me, updates are available, and that's why in order to install them, I will enter Y and hit the enter button. It will download and install all the updates. Now it says here that in order to complete the updates, it has to close the terminal. I will enter Y here and hit the enter button. Now the terminal is gone. Now in order to open up the terminal back, we will click on the start button and here we will search for MSYS2 and here we will open up MSYS2 UCRT64. So once I click on that, the terminal has been opened again. Now here again, we can check for the updates. So it will be pacman space minus SYU. Now this time, again, some updates are available. We will install them. Enter Y and hit the enter button. It will download and install the updates. Now, if updates are available, then you have to install them. If updates are not available, then you don't have to do anything. Now, again, I will run this update command, which is pacman space minus capital SYU. And this time, as you guys can see, it says no updates. Now, if updates are available, I recommend you guys to install them. If updates are not available, then you will see a message like this. You can continue. Now what we do is we will install the GCC compiler for C and C++. In order to install that, we will use this particular command. I will provide this in the description box of this video. You can copy. And after that, we will hit the enter button. Now here, in order to proceed with the installation, I have to enter Y and hit the enter button. It will download and install all the packages. Okay, now once the compiler is installed, next what we do is we will install a debugger. We will install the GDB debugger. In order to install that, we will use this command. Again, I will provide it in the description box. You guys can copy. Here, in order to proceed, I have to enter Y and hit the enter button. It will download and install the debugger. We have to wait for the installation to finish. Now, if any of you guys get the errors like this, then you have to run the command again and try to install it. Okay, now the installation is complete. Now what we can do is we can enter the exit command in here and close the terminal window. Now, the next thing that we have to do is we have to update the path environment variable with the location where we have installed the C++ compiler and the debugger. Now, in order to do that, we will open up the folder where we have installed the C compiler. If you remember, in the beginning of the installation, I asked you guys to remember a location, which is nothing but C msys2. So we will open up that. I will click on the start button, click on this file explorer. I will go to this PC, C drive, and here we can find msys64. We will open up this folder, and here we will find UCRT64 folder. We will open up that, and bin folder is there. We will open it up, and here if we scroll down, we can find C++ compilers. For example, GCC, G++, the debugger, GDB, all these programs are here. Now what we have to do is, we have to copy this path and we have to update the environment variable so that we can use the C++ compilers and the debugger from any folder in this file system. In order to copy this path, we can go to this navigation section and then we will left click here in this empty area. Once we do that, it will highlight the path like this. Then we can right click and copy this. After that, we will click on the start button and we will search edit environment variables. We will find this particular link and we will click on that. It will open up this particular window. Here in the user variables section, we can find path. Click on that. It will be highlighted like this. Then click on edit and here we will click on new and then we will right click and paste the path that we have copied. After that, we will click outside and then we will click on OK and then OK. Now we can close this folder. Now the next thing that we do is we will make sure that we installed C++ compiler and debugger properly. In order to do that, we will click on the start button, search for terminal, open it up, and here we will type in gcc space minus minus version, and when we do that, we will get a message like this. Gcc is the C compiler. If there was any problem while installing, then you will get a message stating that gcc is an invalid command or command not found, something like that. And then we will type in g++ space minus minus version. Again, we will get the version of G++ installed, which is a C++ compiler. And then finally, we will type in GDB space minus minus version. And if we hit the enter button, we get the version of GDB installed. If you get the proper messages like this, the version number can be different, but if you don't get any error message here, then it means that you have installed C++ compiler and debugger. And now we will see how we can download and install Visual Studio code. Now here I will open up the browser. I will open up a new tab and here I will enter the website address as code.visualstudio.com and I will open up the website. Now here we can straight away see the option to download for Windows. We will click on that. It will take us to this download page and the download has begun. Again, we will wait for the download to finish. Now, once the download is complete, if I take the cursor on this downloaded file, then I can find this open file option. I will click on that. It will directly open up the Visual Studio Code installer. And here we will accept the agreement. Click on next. We will not change anything. Click on next. Click on next. And here we will make sure that we check all these checkboxes, you know, which will add the open with code option whenever we right click on a file or a folder. And then we will click on next and then install. Now it will install VS Code. We will wait. Okay, now once VS Code is installed, we will check this box which says launch Visual Studio Code and then we will click on finish. It will open up the Visual Studio Code. So now let us see how we can set up the VS Code for running C++ programs. So first what we do is we will create a workspace. So in order to create the workspace, we will click on this file and then we will click on save workspace as. Here I'm going to go to my desktop and here I will create a folder. So new folder, I will call this folder as C++ programming, and then I will open up this folder, and inside this folder I will create the workspace. I will provide the name as C++ workspace and then click on save. Now the next thing that we do is we will add a folder to the workspace. So we will click on file and then we will click on add folder to workspace. Here we will go to the location where we have saved our workspace. So desktop, C++ programming. Inside this folder, I will create another folder. I will call this as programs. And then I will select this folder and click on add. Now, if you see a message like, do you trust the authors? Then click on yes. Now we will click on this Explorer window. And here we can find the C++ workspace and the programs folder that we have added. Now what we do is we will select this programs folder and then we will click on this new file icon and create a file. So let us say hello.cpp. So a C++ file has been created, and here in this file I will create a simple C++ program. Okay, now here I have created a simple C++ program. Now what we do is we will install some extensions which are required. We will click on this extensions tab and here we will search for C++, and here we can find C++ extensions developed by Microsoft. We will install C++ extension pack. So we will click on the install here for this C++ extension pack. If it says whether you trust the authors, click on trust workspace and install. Now, when we install this C++ extension pack, it installs the C++ extension and also the C++ themes extension. So we will wait for the installation to finish. Now, once the installation is complete, we can hide this extensions section and then we will close this extensions tab. Now here it is highlighting an error. I should use std and then end line, just like this. Now in order to run this program, we will go to the top right section. Here we can find this gear icon, and next to that we can find this particular icon and we can see a down arrow. If we click on that, we have the option run C++ file. We will click on that. Once we click on that, we get these options. Here, since we are working with the C++ program, we will select C++g++.exe. If you are working with the C program and you get this particular option, then you will select GCC. For C++, we select G++. I will select G++. I will click on that. And once I do that, the program will be compiled. And in the terminal section, we can see the output of this program, which is hello world. So this is how we can set up the Visual Studio code for executing the C++ programs. So this is it guys for this video. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials, subscribe to the channel.